most simulation modelers will be using the inbuilt function, that is random numbers or the routines. But some of the modelers may not be having the random numbers. At that time, we require this random variate and we require the random variate to be generated. So the best method for random variate generation is the inverse transform technique, and the technique is been explained in the next slides. Here we are going to see how random variate can be developed based on the distributions. So several distributions have been listed. So the some of the distributions are exponential distribution, uniform distribution, weighable distribution, and triangular distribution. Each of these distributions have their own CDF, and the CDF is called as cumulative distribution function. Based on this cumulative distribution function and on this cumulative distribution function, we apply the inverse transform technique and we obtain the random variate. So there is a mechanism for obtaining the random variate, which is called as inverse transform technique. And in the next slide, we are going to see the inverse transform technique. The inverse transform technique is having an algorithm and with the four different steps. The steps are explained in the next slide. As we have discussed earlier, we are going to see inverse transform technique. And for this inverse transform technique, we require the CDF. So CDF can be represented based on some of the distributions. So in the previous slide, I have shown you several examples of the distributions. So now we have considered the inverse transform technique, and in this inverse transform technique, we have four steps, that is step 1, step 2, step 3, and step 4. So each step is having their own significance. And in step 1, we are going to compute the CDF, that is cumulative distribution function, based on what kind of distribution we are going to use, and based on the variable x. Next, we go to the step 2, where you are going to set the function, that is f of x is equal to r on the range of x. Next, we go move on to the step 3, where you are going to solve the equation, and in this equation we are going to find out the value of x. So the value will be in terms of, or the equation will be in terms of r. So x is equal to some value ranging for r. Next, we go to the step 4, and the fourth step, where we are going to obtain the random variate by the distribution, any of the distribution. And for this distribution, we may require some random numbers, that may be r1, r2, r3, and so on. So your final random variate will be in terms of xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So this equation, that is xi is equal to f inverse of ri, is suitable for all the distributions. So any distribution can be used for computing or obtaining the random variate. And here, based on the distribution, we will be getting the CDF. So it is based on which distribution we are going to use. And in the next slides, we will be seeing several distributions. And based on the distributions, we are going to apply inverse transform technique to obtain the xi value, that is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So now we are going to discuss about the exponential distribution, which is the first distribution what I am going to take for an example, that is exponential distribution. So for this exponential distribution, we are going to apply inverse transform technique, which has four steps. Step 1 is for computing the CDF, step 2 is for setting the function, that is f of x is equal to r, third step is for solving the equation, and the fourth step is for obtaining the random variate for the distribution. So it will be xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So if we see the first step here, that is step 1, for exponential distribution, the CDF f of x is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x, where x is greater than or equal to 0. This equation is obtained by the CDF of the exponential distribution. The CDF of the distribution function f of x is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x, where x is greater than or equal to 0, or it will be 0 if x is less than 0. So based on this CDF, I have taken the first equation, that is 1 minus e to the power lambda x, where x greater than or equal to 0. The step 1 is completed, where I consider the f of x is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x, where x greater than or equal to 0. Next, I move on to the step 2, that is setting the function, that is f of x is equal to r. So what is f of x? F of x value already obtained in the step 1, that is 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x. So I am substituting that value and obtaining the equation, that is 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x is equal to r. I move on to the step 3, where it is for solving the equation in terms of r. So 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x is equal to r. So at the end I get the x value, that is x is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by lambda ln 1 minus r. So this is the x value what is been obtained for the exponential distribution. So this is called a random variate generator for exponential distribution. And we are left out with the last step, that is the fourth step for obtaining xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So it is xi is equal to minus 1 divided by lambda ln 1 minus ri. So ri stands for the random numbers whichever is been given, which is r1, r2, r3, r4 and so on. In the previous slides we have seen the exponential distribution, but here we are going to see the uniform distribution. So in this uniform distribution we need to obtain the CDF. So the step one is, for uniform distribution the CDF is f of x is equal to 0 where x is less than a. Next is x minus a divided by b minus a, where a less than or equal to x, less than or equal to b, and 1, that is x greater than b. So we have taken, or we need to take the f of x value, that is CDF of uniform distribution. So step 1 has been completed of inverse transform technique. So f of x we have obtained. Next we go to the step 2, where we are going to set the function, that is set f of x is equal to r. We need to consider the function, that is f of x. So in this f of x we neglect 0 and 1, and in that we take only x minus a divided by b minus a, which is lying from a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b. So x minus a divided by b minus a is equal to r can be solved. So that solution or the problem which can be solved will be done in the step 3. So go to the step 3 for solving f of x is equal to r in terms of r. And in this, when during your solution or after your solving, we get x is equal to r into b minus a plus a. So this x is the random variate for uniform distribution. So next step is step 4, the final step, where we generate the random variate xi is equal to ri into b minus a plus a, which is equivalent to xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So it is xi is equal to ri b minus a plus a. So xi whatever we have obtained, it is for uniform distribution, and previous xi whatever we have obtained, it is for exponential distribution. So based on the distributions we have obtained the random variates. And in case we have any problems to be solved based on uniform distribution, we need to take xi is equal to ri b minus a plus a as the random variate. As of now we have seen exponential distribution and uniform distribution, and we are left out with two other distributions called as Weibull distribution and triangular distribution. Similar inverse transform technique can be applied on Weibull distribution and triangular distribution, and for taking this we need to have the CDF of Weibull distribution and the triangular distribution. So you can see here at the top we have the Weibull distribution, and the CDF of the Weibull distribution is been displayed to you in terms of f of x. So f of x is equal to 1 minus exp of 1 minus x minus b divided by alpha to the power beta. So now based on this CDF or on this CDF, we are going to apply the inverse transform technique having four different steps, that is step 1, step 2, step 3 and step 4. For step 1 is for identifying the CDF, step 2 is for setting f of x is equal to r, and step 3 is for solving the f of x value equal to r in terms of r, where you get the x value, that is x equal to f inverse of ri. And the fourth step is for obtaining the random variate, that is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So if you go to the Weibull distribution, you can see there the CDF which has been obtained at the top. Next, that is the first step what we obtained, that is f of x is equal to 1 minus exp of minus x divided by alpha to the power beta, where the parameter location v is been considered as 0. So next we go to the step 2 of the inverse transform technique, set f of x is equal to r. We set the f of x value, f of x is equal to r, and we go for the step 3 for solving the function. So by solving the function in terms of r, at the end we obtain x is equal to alpha multiplied by minus ln into 1 minus r whole to the power 1 minus 1 divided by beta. So this is the random variate whatever has been obtained based on your in terms of x. Next we go for the step 4, where we obtain the random variate, that is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So here we have the R that is called as random number, and replace this R by Ri, so that we get the random variate for weibull distribution. Similarly, we go for the triangular distribution, and to obtain this triangular distribution, we require the CDF of the triangular distribution. So in the triangular distribution, we have major A, B and C value, which are called the endpoints of the triangle. So based on this endpoints of the triangle, we can obtain, we can consider, or we can select the f of x. So the CDF of the triangular distribution is f of x is equal to 0 if x is less than or equal to 0. Next is x minus a, this a square divided by b minus a into c minus a, where a less than x less than or equal to b. And next is 1 minus c minus x the whole square divided by c minus b into c minus a, where b less than x less than or equal to c. And the last one is 1, where x is greater than c. So considering all these, CDF is majorly based on the endpoints of the triangle, that is a, b and c. In some of the cases, they may give you, or they will be giving the a value, b value and c value. Sometimes they will be giving only the endpoints in as two endpoints, and another value they will be giving it as mode, any value called as mode. So now we have to consider the two endpoints as A and C, and the mode value as B value. So by substituting the A value and B value and C value, we will be considering, or we will be selecting which CDF has to be taken. So in the previous, in the next slide, what we are going to see, where we are going to apply the inverse transform technique, and in this inverse transform technique, the endpoints are also has been considered. So in the previous next slides, we'll be seeing the endpoints being considered, and we'll solve the inverse transform technique for the triangular distribution, and we'll obtain the random variate for the triangular distribution. So now, based on the a value, b value and c value, we are going to obtain the CDF. So substitute the a value, b value and b value and c value on the CDF and obtain the f of x. So f of x we have 0, where x is less than or equal to 0. Next is x square divided by 2, where 0 less than x less than or equal to 1. And next is 1 minus 2 minus x the whole square divided by 1 square, where 1 less than x less than equal to 2. Another one is 1, where x greater than 2. So we'll be considering 2 f of x, which is f of x is equal to x square divided by 2. And next, f of x is equal to 1 minus 2 minus x the whole square divided by 2. So these are the two CDF what we'll be considering for the triangular distribution. And now we'll come across the step 2 for setting the function values, that is f of x is equal to r. So based on this step, that is f of x is equal to r, we take first f of x, that is x square divided by 2 is equal to r. And we'll be taking 1 minus 2 minus x the whole square whole divided by 2. So we are completed with the step 2 for having the equation. Next is the step 3, where we solve the equations what we have obtained from the step 2. So the first equation what we have obtained from the step 2 is x square divided by 2 is equal to r. We solve this equation in terms of r, and we will be obtaining, that is x is equal to root over 2r. So this is the first random variate for the triangular distribution, that is x is equal to root over 2r. And next we have another one CDF which has been considered, that is 1 minus 2 minus x the whole square whole divided by 2, which is equal to r. Again we solve this equation in terms of r, and we obtain x is equal to 2 minus root over 2 into 1 minus r. So we have obtained two random variate for triangular distribution, that is x is equal to root over 2r, and the other one is x is equal to 2 minus root over 2 into 1 minus r. So these are the two random variate for triangular distribution. So next step is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So here whatever we have got in the step 3, that is x is equal to root over 2r and 2 minus root over 2 minus 2 into 1 minus r, substitute the random numbers and obtain the random variates as per your step 4. Now we are going to solve few problems related to your inverse transform technique based on the CDF which have been given. So So here the CDF is been given. So we'll solve the first question, that is given the CDF f of x is equal to x to the power 4 divided by 16 on 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2, and develop random variate generator for this distribution. So this question clearly tells that we need to obtain the random variate generator based on the inverse transform technique. So inverse transform technique has several different steps. So we'll be solving this problem based on the inverse transform technique by the first step, that is step 1, where we obtain the f of x value. So as per the question being given, f of x is equal to x to the power 4 divided by 16, where 0 less than or equal to x is equal to 2. So step 1 is finished. Next we go for the step 2 for setting the f of x is equal to r. So f of x value is equal to x to the power 4 divided by 16. So x to the power 4 divided by 16 is equal to r is your step 2. Next we go for the step 3, where we solve the equation obtained in the step 2. So f of x is equal to r, we solve this equation in terms of r. So it is x to the power 4 divided by 16 is equal to r. In terms of r, if we solve, you will be getting x to the power 4 is equal to r into 16. And if we get the value, that is x equal to 2 r to the power 1 divided by 4. So this is the random variate, that is x value, what we are obtained based on the step 3, that is inverse transform technique. Next is your step 4, that is xi is equal to f inverse ri. So we have got xi is equal to 2 into ri to the power 1 divided by 4. So this is the random variate what we have obtained in the first question, that is they been solved. Next we move on to the second question to be solved. So the second question is, given the PDF f of x is equal to x squared divided by 9 on 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 3, develop a generator for this distribution. So f of x is equal to x to the power 2 divided by 9. Now we can see in this question, the question being given as PDF, not the CDF. For your inverse transform technique, we require the CDF, not the PDF. So this probability distribution function has to be converted to your CDF, that is cumulative distribution function. And the cumulative distribution function can be obtained by integration of the probability distribution function. So f of x is equal to integration of 0 to x squared divided by 9. If you solve this integration, we get the equation, that is f of x is equal to x cubed divided by 27. So x to the power 3 divided by 27 is the CDF of the second question to be solved. So now step 1 is the CDF has to be identified. So the CDF is f of x is equal to x cubed divided by 27, where 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 3. Next we go for the second step of the inverse transform technique, that is set f of x is equal to r. So x to the power 3 divided by 27 is equal to r, and we start solving it, where we get x cube, that is x to the power 3 is equal to r into 27. And if we solve this, we'll be getting x is equal to 3 into r to the power 1 divided by 3. So this is the value which is being obtained, that is equation being obtained in terms of r. So x is equal to 3 into r to the power 1 divided by 3 on 0 less than or equal to r less than or equal to 1. Next we go for the step 4, we write, that is xi is equal to f inverse ri. So now substitute ri in terms of r and xi in terms of x. So we get in the step 4 xi is equal to 3 into ri to the power 1 divided by 3. So that is the random variate which has been generated for the second question. Now we see the third problem here, that is the given the following CDF for the continuous variable with range from minus 3 to 4. Develop a generator for the variable f of x is equal to 0, where x less than or equal to minus 3. Next is 1 by 2 plus x divided by x, where minus 3 less than x less than or equal to 0. Another equation is 1 by 2 plus x squared divided by 32, that is 0 less than x less than or equal to 4. And the last one is 1, where x greater than 4. So now if we see this CDF, or f of x value in this 0 and 1 can be neglected, and we consider only 1 divided by 2 plus x divided by 6, and another one is 1 divided by 2 plus x square divided by 32. So the values have been ranging from minus 3 to 4. So now we need to apply the inverse transform technique, and inverse transform technique has 4 steps. So based on your step 1, we need to identify the CDF, that is f of x. So we have already obtained the f of x, that is f of x is equal to 1 divided by 2 plus x divided by 6, and another one f of x is f of x is equal to 1 divided by 2 plus x square divided by 32, which lies from 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4. So step 1 is completed. We go to the step 2, and as in your slide you can see step 2, that is for setting f of x is equal to r. So in the previous step 1, we have got two f of x or two functions. So 1 divided by 2 plus x divided by 6 is equal to r, and another one is 1 divided by 2 plus x square divided by 32 is equal to r. So this has been done in your step 2. Next we go for the step 3. Step 3 is for solving the equation or the function in terms of r. So if we solve this, we obtain the random variate, or we are going to obtain two random variate actually. So the first random variate will be x is equal to 6 into r minus 1 by 2 for 0 less than or equal to r less than or equal to 1. And another random variate will be x is equal to root over 32 into r minus 1 by 2. So these are the two random variates which have been generated. That is x is equal to 6 into r minus 1 divided by 2. Another random variate is root over 32 into 1 minus, sorry, root over 32 into r minus 1 by 2. So these are the two random variate. Next step is step 4, which is for obtaining the random variate. That is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. So here we have obtained two random variate, and in the random variate, in place of r, please substitute ri, and in place of x, please substitute xi, and any number of ri value or random numbers have been given, substitute the values and obtain the x value. So we'll be obtaining the random variate value. So we have obtained the random variate, or we have generated a random variable, that is x is equal to, or we have generated two random variable, that is x is equal to 6 into r minus 1 by 2. Another one is x is equal to root over 32 into r minus 1 by 2. Here you can see two different problems, that is fourth problem and fifth problem. And in the fourth problem, it is triangular distribution. You can see the question, that is develop the triangular random variate generator with range 1, 10 and mean of 4. So now you need to clearly see this question properly, where the range is been given as 1, 10. So 1, 10 are the two endpoints which we consider it as a is equal to 1 and c is equal to 10. But here you can see mean of 4, the mean value has been given as 4, but not the mode value. If mode value has been given, we can directly consider it as b value, but here the b value is not been given. So b value has to be considered based on, or identified based on, the mean value. So mean value is equal to 4. So we have an equation, that is e of x is equal to a plus b plus c divided by 3. So by this, e of x we tell it is mean, and a value we know, that is equal to 1, and c value equal to 10, which is already been known. And the equation e of x is equal to a plus b plus c divided by 3, by substituting the a value, c value and e of x value. So e of x value is equal to 4, a value is equal to 1 and c is equal to 10. Substitute the value and obtain the value of b. By substituting the values, we get the b value, which is equal to 1. So which clearly tells that a value and b value is similar or same. So now based on your triangular distribution, that is CDF of the triangular distribution, now we need to identify the f of x. So f of x value, you can see here the value ranges from b less than x less than or equal to c. That is because a value and b value are the same. So in triangular distribution, we had different f of x, that is four different f of x, but the value here what we have taken, it lies between b less than x less than or equal to c. So the value what we are going to take, or the function f of x we are going to take, it is
f of x is equal to 1 minus c minus x d whole square divided by c minus a into c minus b. So this is the function what you are going to take, and the step one has been completed. So step one, we are identifying the CDF. F of x is equal to 1 minus c minus x d whole square whole divided by c minus a into c minus b. Next, we move on to the second step of the inverse transform technique, that is set f of x is equal to r. So now f of x value is equal to 1 minus c minus x the whole square whole divided by c minus a into c minus b, which is equal to r. Now in this equation we have obtained the we have finished the second step. As for your second step, we can obtain or we can substitute the a value, b value and c value, which is already known. C value is 10, b value is 1 and a value is also 1. Next, we move on to the step 3 for solving the equation. So after substituting the values of a, b and c and the equation in terms of r, we start solving the equation and we obtain x is equal to 10 minus 9 root over 1 minus r. So x stands for the random variate, and the random variate is generated, that is x is equal to 10 minus 9 root over 1 minus r. So step 4 is xi is equal to f inverse of ri. In place of r we can substitute ri, and in place of x we can obtain xi, but the random variate generator is x is equal to 10 minus 9 to the root over 1 minus r on 0 less than or equal to r less than or equal to 1. Next, we move on to the fifth problem, that is develop the triangular random variate generator with range 0, 12 and mode 5. Here a equal to 0, b equal to 5 and c is equal to 12. The endpoints have been given, that is 0, 12. So it stands for a equal to 0 and c is equal to 12, and the mode value has been given as 5. So it is clearly telling the b value is equal to 5. I request you people to solve this problem and obtain the random variate based on your inverse transform technique. Thank you.